We are always entering a new environment. We don't ever know fully what the new environment is, because the only environments we know are the past ones.
Ladies and gentlemen, for those passengers on Air Canada Flight 737 for San Francisco, once again, we do apologize for the delay. Just to keep you updated here, as you're noticing, the aircraft is just being towed onto the bridge.
My name is Adit Patel. I'm in a third year of software and embedded system engineering here at Mac.
My name is Jesse Wang. I'm in my second year of mechanical engineering here at McMaster University.
My name is Andrew. I'm in second year mechanical engineering and society.
Hi, my name is Salma. I'm in fourth year chemical engineering.
I'm Justin Lakari. I'm in fourth year computer science at McMaster.
So my name is Elizabeth Marin. I'm in my third year of mechatronics engineering and society, taking a minor in sustainability. It's surreal. Like, I've admired Tesla for years and what they've been doing, and to finally actually get to come here to California and get to see them and meet McMaster alumni working here, I have no words at this point.
I appreciate how they gave a very honest, a very candid insight on what it's like to actually work here. I guess the most surprising thing was that how everyone has a very different background, not necessarily in the auto industry.
Oh, the experience has been amazing. I knew coming into it that the culture and just the feel would be so much different from anything else that I've ever experienced, but I had no idea it would be to such a degree. It's just amazing, the innovation and the thinking processes that go on here.
One thing that's really amazing to see is the culture of technology and how it's kind of seeped out of Silicon Valley into other tech companies around the world. So some, for example, at Facebook, we got to see how hackathon culture really made a difference in how Facebook rolled out their products. We get to see open office spaces as opposed to traditional closed office spaces, and how in Silicon Valley, all of these cultural things are helping people work better and be happier doing what they do.
I like, for me, definitely the Corning Institute, where we got to practice our pitches and we got to speak to people who actually do create startups and fund startups, and just hearing their experiences and their words of advice really helped.
I think the only advice that I would want to give is just believe in yourself. I think that's the biggest thing. Some people just don't try too hard to go for the companies that they have dreamt for because they feel like they're not good enough for those companies. But I would say really push for it, try your hardest, and use all the resources that are at your disposal. Use the university's resources, do networking, make connections, and they're really going to help you later on in your life.
A lot of the times, you know, students don't even think about it. Like when I was in school, I didn't even have the thought of, oh, maybe I can go and intern at Apple or Google. You know, you just don't think about it. So just exposing students to, oh, this is out there, and it's in your realm. This is something that you can get.
Follow your passions and your hobbies. I think, you know, it speaks for itself. You know, stay in school, obviously, finish your school as best you can. I think perform at the highest levels you can, you know, learn to manage your time. But I think also pursue the passions that you have, whether it's, you know, joining a school club or, you know, pursuing a sport, pursuing an activity that you find, like, very, very interesting, because I think those are the things that open more opportunities for you to get jobs that, you know, you're able to then talk about that may have nothing to do with an employer that you may want to work for, but those experiences are all things that you'll be able to use on the job.
It really makes you wonder, like, I'm in mechanical now, it makes you wonder where will I end up down the road.
Meeting McMaster alumni and learning from their experiences of what Silicon Valley is really like has been a highlight for me. Seeing what steps you need to take and like what kind of experiences you will have in the Silicon Valley, especially with a startup, it's really informative. It lets you know that, oh, you can go from anywhere to anywhere. You just have to find the right people, the right products and fit it all together.
It's something I never thought was possible, but now that we're speaking to all these people who graduated from Mac, it's amazing that it's a real opportunity that we can go after.
It really is possible to come down here and work for them. It's not really the dream that's up on a pedestal like it has been in my head. It's, you know, these guys, they went through McMaster, they went and they did a job in Ontario, they got some experience, and then, you know, they came out here and worked for Tesla. And so to me, it was eye-opening to see that such an experience really is within reach for me.